Hello you guys, and welcome to Designer How. We're back with another tutorial for you today, so let's get right into it. Place the two clips you want to transition next to each other on the timeline. Move to the beginning of the clip to which you want to transition, and press the right arrow button to skip one frame ahead. Cut it by pressing Ctrl plus K, or use the razor tool by pressing C. We now have the first frame of the clip. Copy that by holding Alt and dragging it one track up on the timeline. Now right-click and select Add Frame Hold. Stretch it out a bit. As you can see, the frame now holds for as long as our new clip lasts. We'll drag it back with its end on the intersection, because it'll be an integral part to our transition. Head on over to the Effects panel and type in Crop. Now drag the crop effect onto the freeze frame clip. In Effect Controls, select the pen tool under Crop and begin outlining the subject of the desired effect. Don't worry. This doesn't come down to the millimeter exactly, just the general shape. Click the tilde key next to the number 1 on your keyboard to open and close the full screen monitor to make the outlining a little easier. Don't forget to link the last anchor point back to the first one to close the loop. Once closed, it should look like this. Now go back to Effect Controls and under Mask, check the box for inverted. Let's up the feather on our mask a bit. The subject is now isolated. And if we tweak the left parameter under Mask, we can make the background slide in and out as we please. Let's move the timeline to about where we want the slide to happen, and create a keyframe for left. Then move the timeline to about one frame before the next clip, drag the parameter down to 0, and we'll have created our slide in. You'll note that the edge of the frame slide is very sharp right now. Let's soften that a bit by driving up the edge feather parameter to about 53. Not bad, but we're going for nothing less than the pro approach. So let's create a subtle fade-in by keyframing opacity, turning it down to 0, scrubbing forward a little, and then clicking the reset parameter button to bring the next keyframe back to 100. Getting closer. We'll want a stunning glow effect as well, though. So let's duplicate our clip again. Go to Effects, type Directional, and drag the directional blur onto the new clip. In Effect Controls, put Direction at 45 and Blurriness at about 28. Set Blend Mode to Screen. Duplicate the new clip again, but for this one, set Direction at minus 45. Head back to the middle clip and create a keyframe for Direction at 45. On the last frame, create another keyframe with the opposite degrees, so minus 45. Repeat the process for the top clip, but in reverse. So first keyframe at minus 45, last one at 45. Our glow will now twirl and change direction as it goes along. Almost there. Let's head back to the bottom clip and turn off opacity for a second. We want the frame to jump in for a cool effect. Keyframe scale, bring it down to about 7, and keyframe position, and drag the vertical parameter down to where the bottom of our subject is just beneath the edge of the monitor. Just for clarity, I will turn off the visibility for the top two clips real quick. Now scrub the timeline to the last keyframe for opacity and hit reset parameter on both scale and position, bringing our subject in sync with our fade. Turn the visibility for the top two layers back on and, on the bottom layer in Effect Controls, right-click Motion and hit Copy. Then for the top two layers, right-click Motion and select Paste. Let's not forget to put opacity back on upon the bottom clip. There we have it. A stunning slide fit for dazzling all of your friends. They will have to respect you now, won't they? Please like and subscribe, and we will catch you all on the next one.